to me means everything. Well, of course, the charm of the city. And I like to refer to New Orleans as a wonderful, flourishing garden. And I am pleased to be one of the plants in that garden.
Alan Toussaint is one of the great producers in New Orleans music. And now he continues as a kind of a Creole musical godfather. His big influence is Professor Longhair. I mean, Professor Longhair, one of the great piano professors of the city with an African-Caribbean rumba sound. Alan Toussaint, though, goes on to not just be a great piano player that mixes sort of a European Creole sound and almost like Gottschalk now and again, but also rhythm and blues and soul. And, of course, he produced for McCartney, the band, Dr. John.
Looked at as a family-orientated place, you know, and we're like the ambassadors of New Orleans. We bring New Orleans music all over the world, like the Marcelluses.
It's really just an integral part of the way of life of New Orleans. Music is something that's not just viewed as entertainment. It's actually a part of the way people live their lives.
When the levels are off, I'll do something, you know. Because we all have other things that we do. My brother Art has some meters.
Come on, Art, you got it.
Down in New Orleans, in Lucky's Den. Boy, I wouldn't deal now, but I'm with the gym.
My brother Charles has a jazz group, and he works with other jazz musicians. And Cyril has Uptown All-Stars.
The Neville Brothers has played a marvelous part in exposure of the New Orleans music. Also, they have played a very important part in the whole philosophy of it all. Stick to your guns. Never give up.
Trying to catch a cab in the rain. Like trying to flag down a train.
Irma Thomas is a very wonderful lady. She's a great musician. She has a voice that you cannot believe. You cannot believe the voices coming out of that body.
You don't know nothing. You don't know nothing. You don't know nothing. You never had the experience. Don't know what I'm talking about. You never been there. 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 You don't
She was a waitress in a club, and a guy named Tommy Ridgely, who had a band then, asked her if she wanted to sing, and that's how her career got started.
Well, I was supposed to be waiting tables, and I decided I wanted to sing with the band and got up there and sung, and the boss fired me.
Sitting home alone, thinking about my past.
But the gentleman, Tommy Ridgely, whose band was playing at the time that I got fired, took me on an audition, and that's how I got in the business. I auditioned like today, and 2-3 days later, I had a song. Well, Dorothy Labastre introduced the song to me the same day I auditioned. And I took the song home to learn it. And 2-3 days later, I was in the studio. And the next couple of weeks, I had a record out. And a few weeks after that, it was in the charts. And then a few weeks after that, they snatched it off the radio because they said it was too suggestive. So, I mean, it went through a full circle.
And when she gets lonely,
she give the people New Orleans from a female point of view. And even if you didn't know it, if she just starts singing and you didn't know who she was, you would say, yeah, that must be what they're speaking about when they say New Orleans.
Fats Domino is the man who bridges New Orleans rhythm and blues into popular rock and roll, who crosses over between the R&B audiences, the black audiences, and then the white audiences. He has a great classic, basic, but very Caribbean-sounding piano style, heavy on the 2-4 beat.